Hey, it's Scott Orn at Kruze Consulting, and today we're talking about startup bookkeeping and a sneaky little error that could be a big error, which is missing a bank account. Now, of course, many of you are sitting there going like, how can an accounting firm miss a bank account? Well, the usual way it happens is we're looking in QuickBooks, minding our own business, categorizing all the transactions, doing the reconciliation every month, and all of a sudden, we see a really big transfer, like $5 million or $10 million. Our company's raised a lot of money. So all of a sudden we see this transfer out of the company, out of QuickBooks, out of whatever their bank account is. Maybe it's SVB, First Republic, Mercury. And we almost have a heart attack because we're like, oh my gosh, that's $10 million. What's going on here? But experience has taught us what that usually means is the founder has opened up another bank account, usually like a high yield money market account, something like that. And we just don't have access to it. So we just don't have the other side of the equation. It's kind of like a math equation. And we just don't have the equals after portion of it. So we contact the founder and sure enough, almost every single time we get access to the new bank account, we plug that into QuickBooks, we sync, we do the cash reconciliation, and boom, there's the other 10 million, other side of the $10 million. And the company's financials look perfect again. But for that moment when we're missing the bank account, all we have is a cash outflow and we don't have the cash coming back in into those banks, into the balance sheet. So it's a really big deal for the startup's financials. It's a really big deal for us on fraud prevention and not having heart attacks because we think someone took $10 million out of the company. So founders, if you're out there, whenever you start that money market account or other bank account, always let your startup bookkeeper know. You'll save us a lot of headache. Now, there's one addendum to this, which is really important, which is this is how we catch people committing fraud. There's a lot of times, not a lot, I should say, maybe one in 30, one in 40, one in 50, something like that, where we come into a company, the CEO has kind of, you know, maybe had some sloppy bookkeeping or let someone on the team do it, no division of labor, no multi-level review, and all of a sudden, every month we start seeing like a 5,000 or 10,000, something kind of material transfer out into to pay a credit card that we don't have access to, that the company may not have access to. And it turns out in that kind of one in 40, one in 50 situation, someone at the company who's been doing the bookkeeping has been paying their own credit card with the company's funds. And we know that's the case because we can actually see the bank, the credit card number, like the account number on the credit card, where the money's going to, but we don't have the liability side of that. We don't have the actual credit card expenses coming in to match. And so we always go to the CEO and say, hey, who's been doing your bookkeeping? Is it possible that this credit card is not owned by the company and perhaps there might be some fraud here? I think we've caught four or five companies in the last couple years doing this. So if you're a founder and you are having someone on your team do the bookkeeping, please check it. Always make sure that they're not paying their own credit cards. This is a super easy way to catch fraud. And it's kind of one of the nice benefits of working with Kruze Consulting, having us do your startup bookkeeping. We catch this stuff. We actually have caught this many times and no one likes it, but it's always better to know before the problem gets really big. Hope that helps on the sneaky little error that we see sometimes, which is QuickBooks or the company is missing a little bank account, we always fix it. I hope this tutorial helps you know how to fix it. Thanks.